Morning! Welcome to Castaway Cay Day. We've just had our breakfast delivered. Morning!
Would you like me to walk you through our delicious selection of
Why don't you? So we ordered this via this little hook thing that you get in the drawer. And you can put little numbers on how many things you want of things, and then as long as it's on the door by 3 a.m. it will magically appear.
Two fresh fruits.
Oh.
A coffee.
Yes.
Adam prefers cream in the coffee, and I prefer milk in the coffee. And then we also got...
For you, sir, bon appetit. Pastries and donuts.
And donuts, because when you're on a cruise... Why not get donuts for breakfast?
We are just arriving.
Oh, you locked it.
Oh, for God's sake.
We will never fully understand that this door.
So because you're reversing, if you are on the starboard side, the right side of the ship, you will see this view in Castaway Cay, which is of the island and the beaches and stuff. However, if you're on the left-hand side, the, what's that called? Starboard port side, then you'll get a view of everything being unloaded from the ship, and you might be able to get an indication of when the ship's going to be cleared to actually get off. So, both have their perks. I think I personally prefer, I don't know, it depends what I feel like, but this is a pretty spectacular view to have in the first thing in the morning. Tell you what's really convenient is going to the concierge lounge to go and get yourself a big glass of ice. You can actually request a glass of ice on the slip, and they normally will bring it. However, I completely forgot, so it's quite handy to just have that there. Look at the set, you've done such a nice presentation.
Thank you. Well, it's all for Instagram.
Definitely worse places to have breakfast, aren't they?
Certainly are.
The buzzards.
If you see a little boat like this coming in before your day on Castaway Cay, this is all the local Bahamian people coming in to work on the island, because they have some Bahamian shops and they also have some cast members that live locally. Time to get ready for the day, and this is a bit exciting. I've partnered with ZAVVI previously, and they've just launched their Disney 100 collection and added some new lines as well. They've also got some more drops coming later this year. But in celebration of all of that, we are putting together a competition to give you the chance to win a £100 ZAVVI voucher. And then two runners-up are also going to win a prize. Someone's going to win a £50 ZAVVI voucher, and someone's also going to win a Lego wildflower bouquet set. So, I've got some choices to make today in terms of what I'm going to wear. These are all from the Disney 100 collection. We have the P.Sherman 42 Wallaby Way Sydney, but this might be a bit too warm, maybe for the flight home. I love this Wally t-shirt, and if there's something here that you'd see that you don't necessarily like, you might find something on the collection via the link in the description. They've got things from Hercules, Finding Nemo, also got more Toy Story selections. Very cool. If you'd like the chance to enter the competition and win, all you have to do is go to the link in the description. That will get you one free entry by completing the entry form. If you see something from the ZAVVI collection and you go and make a little purchase before the closing date, which is on screen now, and you're UK and 18 plus, you can enter your order number in the entry form and get four complimentary entries. So that's five for the price of one if you make a purchase. But otherwise, check out the full terms and conditions in the link in the description. If you happen to make a purchase, don't forget to use my offer code, because I get your discount, Adam100. So thank you very much to ZAVVI for choosing to work with me. I hope you enjoy, and now it's time to get ready. I think I'm gonna go Wally, because it's very Castaway. We like a yellow.
Outfit reveal.
Oh my God, where'd you get that?
Disney World a couple years ago.
I love it.
I want my keys on it.
Can I steal it? That's a no. Today is very exciting because we've got a cabana. I've never had a cabana, and these are incredibly difficult to get. To put it in perspective, this is my 12th cruise with Disney, and this is the first time I've been able to get one. And that's predominantly down to being a concierge. So concierge guests get the first pick of being able to book a cabana, And I think it also helped that I'm a Platinum member as well, because there's like 76 cabins in Concierge on the ship. So if they're all competing for cabanas, and there's only 20 something of them, not everyone's gonna get one.
Too lucky.
But we had an envelope delivered on the door last night, which has a couple of wristbands and some information about the cabana, where we go for pickup and stuff like that. So we'll put these wristbands on and head out to the island. To Castaway! Castaways, we are castaways. Found one of the little ducks.
Closing.
It's a cruise thing, people hide ducks around the ship. Oh, what luck, you found a duck. Keep or hide, and you decide. But only me in the public places. Please, no shops or pools.
This is
fun. You have to hide it.
Where are you going to hide it?
I don't know.
Oh,
this is not us. This is about 8 floors above. So when debarking the ship, you'll need your cruise ID and... Oh, do you have your passport with you?
No.
Neither do I. Do you have your driving license?
No.
Okay, yeah, we need that.
So yes, learn from our mistake. You need photo ID if you're over the age of 18. They don't accept UK driving license, so I need my passport, and Kieran will take your US driving license. And you also need to make sure that if you are going under the age of 18, you need to have parental consent to do so. And also if you are going off with someone who's in a different cabin, if you're under the age of 18. So you need to get a form for guest services to clear that process.
Passport acquired, take two. And I want to hide this little duck. So, I'm just gonna, there's a little thing there. So if I pop it there. And I like the fact that they've got a pun that says, congratulations.
The ship was cleared about 8:30 a.m. But I personally had to wait like at least half an hour because everyone's rushing to get off the ship. So the first half an hour at the gangway is a bit crazy. But Kieran's just noticed that it's literally dead now.
Feels like there is nobody around. Like coming out of our room into the elevators, it's totally dead.
And also we can going down from 12 to 1 in one fell swoop.
Woohoo!
Whilst you cannot do that when the gangway has just been cleared.
Wow.
Hello. How are you?
Good to have our dues.
Yeah, very well, thank you.
That's it.
And
thank you. Welcome to paradise.
Hey. Pretty cool. This is going to be our first decent look at the ship.
Oh yeah, because we haven't digged it off. So yeah. I haven't seen it.
Doing some cleaning. As you disembark, they do have a selection of towels, so you don't have to take towels with you. You have to take them from here, but you don't have to bring them from the room. We have got, bless you,
sorry.
We have got towels in the cabana, so we don't have to worry about those today, which is nice. We are Serenity Bay side, and there's only four there, and they're the cheaper ones. They're $399 for the day, and that's the cheaper one. The family ones, I think, are $569 or $599. And then there's the really, really big one, which is like $949, which can hold up to 10 guests. As you get off, there's this little raised platform. And if you head up here, you can get a nice picture with the back of the ship. And on our occasion, it's Rapunzel. Ash, who was doing our walking tour yesterday, said that she has a size 22 shoe of Rapunzel on this ship. And it took 600 hours to make and like
70
Imagineers,
yeah. So crazy.
There you go, appreciate it.
Those people already heading up, heading back to the boat?
Quite possibly. Well, no, some people do they do a 5K on the ship, on the island, sorry.
Oh, wow.
And you can get
on vacation. What are you talking about? Doing a run?
I don't know. But people like running. I think that's a vacation for some people.
True.
But not me. So these are some of the Disney shops where they have some Castaway Cay merch if you want a t-shirt.
A bit of a flex to have a Castaway Cay spirit jersey.
Is that you saying you're going to get one?
No, I don't like the color.
I met this little fine thing out there in the island.
my favourite song of the Castaway Cay loop. Mr. Harry Styles, Watermelon Sugar High. Watermelon Sugar High. Now, if you're coming out to the beach, my advice is walk as far as you can before you get a spot. That is the same for Serenity Bay as it is for the family beach. Most people just see, oh, a sun lounger, and go and sit in it. So the further you can walk, the more quiet you will have. I mentioned earlier that they have Bahamian cast members come and work on the island, and that's for these kinds of shops. So if you want to buy some Bahamas merch, you'll need some dollars. I come out of the bathroom and you're picking melted chocolate out of a wrapper.
What a little chocolate would be. I kept, you know, I have to eat every 30 minutes
apparently. If you're checking into a family cabana or one of the grand cabanas, you're going to do it at this check-in here. Otherwise, you need to catch the tram from this stop here and go over to Serenity Bay, which is where our cabana is, number 23. Oh, I missed it. They did a little
I'm sure
they'll
do it again.
Like the Disney trams. Welcome to Serenity Bay. This is the barbecue where we'll get our lunch. Bike rentals. And this is cabana check-in.
Hey.
Hey. Everyone out is going out. Morning, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good, how are you? Oh, we've already done that. Checking in.
Which room are you?
I don't think 23, I think.
23. So Adam and Kieran.
Adam and Kieran.
Yep.
Yep.
Adam and Kieran.
Yeah. I thought you said Gary.
I thought you said Gary, that's my other friend. Just checked in and now we're getting a private transfer on a golf buggy. This is very bizarre.
Oh,
oh, awesome.
Here we go.
Thank you.
That's a very short journey.
Hattan and Wright. Well, welcome, Matt. Oh, wow.
Yes.
First time, yeah.
Holy moly.
Wow. My first impressions are, could cry at any second. This is insane. It's way bigger than I thought it would be.
Yeah.
Should I do a room tour?
Room
let's
tour.
Do a room tour. I'm just gonna drop my bag off. Okay, so let's go to the front. This is what it looks like from the outside. Kieran, would you like to show us inside with your fantastic Hawaiian shirt?
Yes, looking the part.
Little welcome mat. There is a door so you can close it off so you've got full privacy if you wish.
Hand washing station with H2O products.
Very nice. Over here you've got sunscreen. In the cupboard, you have towels, a safe, and some facial tissues. So if you want to lock your stuff away before you go in the sea, you can do that. More towels down here and your trash. Got some snacks, including Nature Valley bars, a selection of crisps. And in the fridge, which
is the best part.
This is the best part.
Oh gosh.
Cold towels, fruit. Diet Coke. Hey, oh,
my favorite. Only four though. I'm gonna need at least 18.
Well, if you need more, there's a little magical button which, if you press it, our lovely cabana host, which I've never had before, will come and take care of us. There is some indoor seating here, and outside we have a chaise. Never seen a chaise in a like a beach form before. Two sun loungers, we've got complimentary use of tubes and floaty mat things? Boogie boards, what are they called? Boogie boards?
The mat thing?
Yeah.
No.
I think it's a boogie board.
Is it? Boogie boards aren't usually bendy.
Mat things, we have mat things. a very nice hammock, which I'll be making full use of at some point.
Let me test this puppy out.
Please fall off, please fall off, please fall off.
Oh my gosh, yes.
Yeah?
This is the life.
You happy?
Ah, so good.
And there's also a outdoor shower here as well, which I don't know how to use apparently. How do you use it? Oh, just have to push really hard. And that is our view. There's also a curtain here, so if you wanted to go in the corner, pull that across and get changed so you don't show your bits. That is A, okay. He's straight in there. There are fans in the ceiling as well, so if you're chilling in here, you can just enjoy a gentle breeze. But, oh, this is something else. I've never had anything like this before. And I'm quite happy.
Yeah, incredibly grateful to Adam for letting me join him on this.
My pleasure. I have this like nature of like, okay, what next, what next, what next? But actually the whole day is just do nothing.
We're gonna be going between this lounger, this hammock, and the sea. Like, I don't think it can get any better than that.
Well, it could.
How?
A pina colada when I start serving. Which is it's like a pina colada, but it's got a bit of raspberry infusion in it, and I get it virgin. It's the best.
Sounds
incredible. Best beach drink. Well, a walk to the sea isn't exactly long. Look how beautiful the water is though.
It's just like dead still.
So you see, if you walk down the beach as far as you want, there's no one down there, and this is a full cruise as well. Basically, the sooner you get down here and the further you go down the beach, the nicer experience you're going to have on Serenity Bay, in my experience. Oh, that is a bit chilly, isn't it? It's March, isn't it? So I suppose it's had all winter to cold.
It's not terrible, though.
Little fish? I think they have a name, but I can't remember what they are.
That one's Brian. That one's Sandy.
There's Judith. Wildlife with Adam and Kieran. There's a little bird in the net.
Where? Oh my gosh.
Wildlife with Adam and Kieran. That's the second one. We have friends.
Oh, that's so cute.
We should name them. Hyacinth and Robert.
Let's make one Honorable Gary.
Oh no, Gary doesn't like birds. He wouldn't like being named a bird. Okay. Kieran and I just took the tubes out, so we sat out there for about 30 minutes, just chilling in the sun, taking it all in. Very nice. I would actually recommend renting a tube, but
I have returned.
Did you enjoy the tubing?
It was incredibly relaxing.
Very relaxing.
It will not be the last time I will be doing that.
Just keep an eye on the breeze, because we went out quite far and we're like, we should probably go back towards the beach.
If you fell asleep in this thing, you would end up in the middle of the ocean.
Yeah, you'd end up on the new lighthouse point or something. I'm about to start a book which was recommended by my friend Sam, What If It's Us, by Becky Albertelli. I think she wrote Simon versus the Homo Sapien Agenda, which turned into Love, Simon, and Adam Silvera. So looking forward to giving this a read. But otherwise, no qualms, no complaints, just serenity and happiness over here. It just got even better. The lovely bartender was passing through, offered me a drink, so I just got myself a little pina colada. Very, very happy. I do need a wee though, so I'm just gonna pop back before I start relaxing.
That is good. Very raspberry-ish.
Very Castaway Cay.
Yum. That's really good. I have to get one of those.
We were just talking about like how many people you could very easily fit in here, and considering this is $399.
Yeah, if you had like a group of, you know, two couples or four friends, like $100 each for this is pretty good.
Yeah,
I think that'd be worth it for sure.
I mean, even just having like unlimited drink supply, and our cabin host is very, very hospitable.
Yeah,
like he insists on taking us the 22nd golf cart journey. But yeah, no, it's absolutely amazing, and obviously, well, it works out at $200 a person for us. But if you had four, you could very easily have someone on a chaise, two people on beds, someone on the little hammock, maybe someone's chilling in there on their iPad. You know,
yeah, just all the options.
All the options. It's lovely. It's 11:30 a.m. and lunch has just opened. I personally recommend either going really early or really late for lunch. They do start packing up a bit early before 2, but we're gonna push the button because our cabin host really, 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 really likes driving the golf cart. As if by magic.
So
Yes, please.
Let's go.
11:30 a.m. when it's just opened. It is not busy at all. We've got ice cream here, cookies, and we've got a whole salad selection and stuff off the barbecue like hot dogs, burgers. The selection I've gone for is so colourful and looks so fresh. I'm so excited about it.
Mine, on the other hand, is all brown.
I didn't mean to do that. You've got spare ribs, burger, some salad.
Little brownie, cookie.
I am much more of a savoury than I am a sweet, but we'll go back for ice cream later. One thing we've learned the hard way is that the second the birds smell food, they are at your feet. So in the seating area by the barbecue, there is wires and stuff to kind of prevent birds. So it might be worth just staying there to eat, but because we were just talking about Gary would not be happy with birds floating around him whilst he's having his food, so.
Yeah, very persistent.
The food quality is great. Really, really good. What do you think? For a barbecue on a private island?
Very tasty.
Are you right there?
Just trying to put this up. Oh, that's the furthest one. I thought there might be one more.
No, afraid not. Wildlife with Adam and Kieran. I've been reading my book so far. So good. Just popped to get some ice cream before the lunch closed.
Ice cream is great.
Everything is great.
I told Adam I didn't want the ice cream. He bought it anyway. I've nearly finished it.
Honestly, this has been outstanding. And whilst it's quite warm, it is absolutely beautiful. We're coming to the end of our time at the beautiful Cabana, and we're going to be heading back to the ship very shortly. They do offer to take you back to the ship via a golf buggy. However, I think they might be understaffed today because we had to book a time in order to go back. Otherwise, we would have to take the tram back. So we thought, might as well book a time and then go on the golf buggy. It's not every day you get the chance to be driven back to the ship. Although, mind you, this is your first time, so.
I agree.
You're eating a Twix, I'm sorry. but yeah, it's been great. I think my only pro tip to you would be, if you get a Cabana, is be careful about walking around with your bare feet, because there are splinters in the type of wood, and you don't want to end up with a nice piece of wood in your feet. I'm telling you now, my highlight of this whole experience, has been being on Castaway longer than I ever have, just because we've had this base and it's been nice and comfortable, not too hot. But the cold towels. I'm a cold towel person. I'm very happy about it.
It is hot out here, so it's really nice.
That was very Gary-y of you.
Very
yeah, thank also you. Yes. Holding up the golf buggy to take a picture of the sign.
Oh, this is a fun way to sit.
This is great.
Have you guys ever done a Cabana before?
No, it was our first time.
Are you now just completely tainted for the rest of your life?
Oh, yeah, 100. I'm not. I don't think I could come back to Castaway Cay without wanting to try and book another one.
Yeah.
Have you done? Nice. Have you done it before?
No, this is our first time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's amazing.
There she is. Beautiful Disney wish. Little Easter egg on Castaway Cay.
Do you think they recently changed it from Bob Chapek?
I think Bob Iger was always here, okay. And I think Bob Chapek had something on the post office.
Scratch that off.
It was actually taken out. It's so beautiful. I don't want to go home tomorrow. No. Three nights is not long enough. I'm putting it out there, right? If you're booking a Disney cruise, 3 nights is not long enough. It's better than nothing, don't get me wrong, but
I love that, like, we're sad about leaving the Cabana for about like 30 seconds, because then we get to the ship and we're like, oh yay, we're going back on the ship.
Should we go and have a pre-dinner cocktail? A lovely nice cream. Ooh, we have presents. What is this? As a token of our appreciation, we would like to treasure this limited edition lithograph created by Don Ducky Williams for Concierge Family sailing aboard the Disney Wish. Woo! Let's have a look. Ooh! Captain Mickey and Captain Minnie's magical fleet.
Very nice.
Very cute. And a certificate of authenticity as well.
Just getting ready for dinner, and last night we were delivered our automatic gratuities on this paper here. I can't show you the front because it's got people's legal names on the stuff, and they don't necessarily want that on the internet, but they have tear-off slips from each person in your stateroom to each server who's assigned to you, each stateroom host that's assigned to you, etc. So you can, in theory, put it in these little envelopes and deliver it to them personally and say, thank you for looking after us. If you want to put extra cash, you can put that in there. I don't think I've ever taken a cruise where I haven't over-tipped from the automatic gratuities, because the crew are always amazing, and this cruise even more so than previous. I don't know how they did it, but they went above and beyond. Additionally, on the gratuity front, if you are in Concierge, like we are, you will get this piece of paper, which allows you to basically write the tip that gets shared among the Concierge team and the Concierge servers, which can be charged to your account. So rather than actually putting cash in there, you could just put it on here and they'll automatically charge it, which might actually be more convenient for you if you'd like to do a larger sum than what you might have in cash. We met a couple on the golf buggy that had counted the paces or the steps back to the Concierge Lounge from their room. They said 17.
17. So they're pretty close.
We want to see if we're closer or further.
Okay. So we're walking out. Hi.
Hi.
How are you doing?
Yes. Okay, right first.
Okay.
What?
That's my left foot.
Sure, that's your other right. Okay. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 12, 13, 14. It's not looking good. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Okay, not far off. The best. I love it.
Two reasonably clumsy people carrying martinis up a flight of stairs. It's not the best thing. On a moving ship as well. Oh, I saw a drop.
Oh no.
Thank God the door is automatic, that's all I'm gonna say. Evening menu in the Concierge, we've got an arancino stuffed with bolognese. Oh, that sounds amazing.
Yeah, for sure.
Salmon, moussaka, I love moussaka.
And a banh mi.
One of everything?
Why not? Oh, yeah. Spaghetti and meatball tacos. I think I saw that coming out and it looked good. Even though it's on the kids menu. This, like, you can ignore
the kids menu doesn't mean anything. Yeah. That chicken pot pie thing was not a kids thing in my opinion, but I think it'd be rude not to try everything.
I think so. It's our last night.
Yeah. So we were sat here and a notification came up on our phone saying like Aladdin starts in just 15 minutes. And we were like, we definitely got the time wrong.
Yeah.
And we just decided that we're gonna skip it because this just turned up. Oh my God! This is our pre-dinner.
Yeah, it may look like dinner, but this is not dinner. This is the dinner before the dinner.
It's salmon, moussaka, arancini, kids spaghetti meatball taco, and then a chicken sandwich or something?
I have no idea. I don't
know. Okay, well,
your guess is as good as mine.
We're gonna try it all. You did so well with the espresso martini.
I'm just happy it's on my leg and not on my shorts.
Mmm. That's what I call a 5 out of 5. Very good. Right.
Cool. Adam just choking on his espresso. I mean, your martini.
I'm fine. Okay, so, is that a mushroom? Oh. Be free!
Scary mushrooms.
Whoa.
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know.
The first thing of the cruise that's a maybe.
I think there's a lot of flavors going on in one dish.
Okay.
Some of it's cold, some of it's hot.
Oh, interesting. That can throw it off for sure.
I'm just gonna stick with I don't know.
Okay, okay. Well,
I don't know if I like it or not.
The good thing is,
neither agree nor disagree.
There are plenty of other options to eat.
Safe to say the food was demolished. I didn't have the burger in the end because I think it was pork and that's not my vibe. But the spaghetti and meatball taco was
pretty good.
Delicious. Yeah. The kids know where it's at.
Tinity is crystal clear. Oh, it's a jolly holiday with you, bud.
Thought someone was coming through then. I was about to be very embarrassed. Right, we're heading down to the shop. Skipping the show is very good if you want to get the ship when it's very, very quiet.
Yeah.
Because first seating are having dinner, and five, I think it is. Everybody else is in the show.
Doors closing.
Got my.
KIERAN couldn't help himself.
Free dinner dessert.
Playing music from Cinderella. I love it.
Very relaxing interview.
Very magical. And is this the part where? Oh no, it's transitioned to a different song. Never mind. Ooh, it is dead in here. And it's normally very quiet, very busy on the last day. Oh well, that's just adorable.
Let's see, $49.99.
I don't think that's too bad for Disney prices, you know.
Not too bad. Not too bad.
The only thing I don't like is the year, because yeah. I don't like it when things are dated.
I agree.
I would happily have this T-shirt if it was just
as
is Disney Cruise Line, but without the year.
This is so cute for some reason.
How much is it?
Let's see. $22.99, which actually is pretty reasonable.
It's a nice little souvenir for a kid or KIERAN. I love this.
$34.99.
It's cool.
I like that.
Very cute. I mean, it's got it's a bit gold and shiny for me, but
yeah, I don't generally do red, but I like the design.
You're a cool tone.
Yes.
I'm a whatever fits me. We found hats, and they look very nice. How much is this one?
This one is $34.99.
That's not bad, I think, because that's a Nike hat, isn't it?
It is, yeah. Nike. Not too bad.
They've got some cool apparel here. There's a little chocolate or vanilla swirl hoodie there. Mini looking fabulous.
Yeah, very summery.
How much is the dress? $44.99. I don't think that's bad for that.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Look at this.
What is that?
Look at that. And that.
I like this one. Unless, has it got some big print
garish
in the back?
Oh, no! Because that's the thing I said in the last Wish series, is like, I just want like a plain little emblem here, and I'm fine with that, Disney.
Yeah.
And they actually have got something like that.
They did it. They listened to you, Adam.
I don't think they did, but I was looking at this hoodie, and then on the back, I saw this. And it's just, I know that that's not going to wash well, because it'll pull and shrink and stuff. So, yeah, I like it, Disney, but only the front. We didn't try the beignets!
Do you want to?
No. Maybe after dinner.
I can't stomach anything.
I can't, yeah.
Maybe after dinner.
Yeah. I will
remember you. Treasures Untold. It is a bit fancy in here. They might have taken away the Disney stuff because I see mostly handbags. Oh no, there it is.
Cinderella.
KIERAN's like, oh, I really like this shirt. I was like, I'm pretty sure you're wearing the exact same shirt earlier.
This is a little more subtle.
It's a bit lighter than the one you were wearing earlier. It's nice though. How much is it? Oh, it's over there. $135. Very nice Dooney and Burke bags in here. Inaugural Wish sailing. Don't even want to know how much it is. I'm just going to leave. Little Tiffany necklace there. Oh, only $1,300.
Wow.
But no tax. So, you know.
There you go. That's one benefit, I suppose.
Hyperspace. Oh, hang on. Wait for the door to close. Okay, go ahead. Go and push the button. We're not big drinkers, so we're not actually stopping in hyperspace for a drink. But let's have a look around. And this is what cruise life is all about. Sunset, golden hour, beautiful ocean views. We are booking it.
Yeah.
So we're running back really to Port Canaveral. No, don't let the cruise end that quickly. Come on.
Slow down.
It's getting busy in the old atrium today. Everyone wants to meet the characters, including us. Hi, Minnie. How you doing? You're looking fantastic in your captain getup. Can I get a twirl? Oh, yeah. Ahoy!
How's the sailing there? Is it nice and smooth?
It's nice and smooth.
Incredible job.
KIERAN is very excited to meet you.
Yes, very excited. Captain Minnie, my gosh. We love to sing it.
It's about time, right?
Yes. Absolutely.
Thank you. Thank you.
Bravo! Bravo! Encore!
And this is Lady Lily, and we are the fairy tale players.
The people are the time.
Yeah. Yeah. Welcome to Tito. Yeah.
Hello! Oh, lovely to see you.
Oh, my
hello, my darling.
Sir. Nice to see you.
Lady Lily,
hello.
Cousin Lord Leopold.
Hello, sir.
You're you. Looking wonderful. We've been wonderful. Well, I mean, Gary's transformed.
Yeah, he's transformed. Different from last time.
Yes, yes. Do you know any stories?
Do you have a favorite?
We're going to Arendelle later.
Oh,
we can do Frozen. Yes.
Okay, great. And now the story of Frozen in 1 minute. Yes.
Do you want to build the snowman?
No.
Sir?
Yes.
Can we open the gates?
No.
Elsa?
Oh, yes.
Can I marry this man I just met?
You? No.
Elsa?
Yes.
Why do you always shut me out?
Let it go.
Elsa?
Yes.
Can you stop the winter and bring back summer?
I can't.
And yes. Kiss me so I don't freeze.
No.
I'm frozen.
Anna, no.
An act of true love can fill a frozen heart and see.
Bravo, bravo, encore. The globe must be calling you. On the way to Arendelle, we've just spotted this moving art. It's very cool. Oh, wow. This is fantastic. I love this. I wish they had more things like this in Disney World. You know, just dotted around the hotels and stuff.
Well, at Disneyland, they have those big moving windows in the...
Well, we can't all live in Disneyland, okay? Walt Disney World is much more convenient
and affordable for me.
Do you want to build a snowman?
Yes.
They're applauding all the Disney princesses. This is so cute. Hi, 5'10".
5'10", welcome back, guys.
Thank you very much.
5'10".
Good, how was it in Castaway?
Wonderful, yes, wonderful.
Right. Wonderful weather, right?
We baked in the sun, we liked it. Oh, wow.
I think this is the best thing.
Oh my gosh, okay. Well, this is great for the vlog. Wow, oh my goodness, thank you so much.
Do you want to sit here so you can get more of
it? Yeah, sure.
I'm going to assume we have the table because we're in concierge. Oh, that would make sense. Yeah.
You don't just get a table like this. for no reason.
It's not interactive, is it?
It's just not like get up on stage and sing with us. So, but we'll have to look like we're singing along. So okay. Just we'll mime. Because right. You don't sing.
I don't sing.
If my memory serves me correctly, this is my favorite menu of the whole cruise.
Ooh, okay.
So, we have appetizers, salads, and soups here. We have the entrees, vegetarian and light note. Thank you so much, Roberto. I think we've both decided on the Jarlsberg cheese and rosemary ham tart, the carrot soup, and I'm going to go for the cod, and Kieran is going for
the ribeye.
The ribeye.
For that ride, skin free.
You have such a wonderful voice.
Welcome to the great job. I'm really impressed. It's his first party ever, so we were a little bit nervous.
Oh, really?
I think it's going well so far.
It's going great.
Oh, me too.
I heard that's the best
one. Okay.
Family recipes.
Oh, really? Yeah. Hello.
Yes, please.
Oh, look at that rock.
Can't take all the credit. My family helped me pick it out.
Was it a year's salary?
Oh, it was enough carrots that spam was a little jealous.
Okay, you sold a lot of carrots to the restaurant, I am assuming.
Yeah.
Yes?
So if you don't finish any, I'll give it to him later.
Thank you so much. So this is the cheese and ham tart. Let's have a little looky-loo. So this is what it looks like. It looks like a quiche, if I'm honest.
It does, yeah.
As you know, I pay for everything so we can give you the honest review. The cheese and ham tart. Not a bit of me, not a bit of Kieran.
Yeah. I'm eating it because I'm polite.
The carrot soup? Thoughts?
It's like carrots. I like it. It's good.
I don't know why I found that so amusing.
We're both hilarious.
We're at that point now. We've been getting up early every day to try and get the most out of this cruise, but we are knackered.
Carrots.
Yeah, it tastes like carrots.
Thank you.
Such big men, such small crops.
Palo's a bit different, but what's your review of Arendelle?
I enjoyed it. I mean, my food was good, the entertainment is really great, like the singers, the violinists especially, incredible.
Yeah,
I guess my only critique is maybe it is quite loud in here, which is just the nature of like a really big restaurant.
Yeah. Because I guess with 1923 you've got rooms that break it up.
Yeah.
Whilst in here it's just one degree. I think because of just where we are in the restaurant, even though we've got a great vantage point for the show, we're hearing everything. So
yeah,
that's only negative, but otherwise
it's good overall.
Yeah. Like the show, the entertainment is what makes this restaurant special. Yes. From the other ones.
Yes.
Just to give you an indication of how loud it is, Kieran's watch told him to leave because it's too loud. As we're leaving the restaurant, a little fun fact for you. So these busts are actually the fourth versions of these busts made. The original ones had the ladies in the wrong dresses. The second one had the crown on Elsa's head, not Anna's, because that's not the way around, because this is based on Frozen 2. And then the third ones were so good that they ended up in the Walt Disney archives. And then the fourth ones were made to actually come into the restaurant. So we learned that on the Walking the Wish tour. We've come from Arendelle and found our way into the lobby. We're going to find a good spot to see they have a farewell show, which is like, thank you for sailing on the Wish from everyone at Disney. Toodaloo.
Your very last chance to see all the gang.
Yeah.
Mickey, Minnie.
Hello, Disney Wish. You had a magical crew. So let me hear you say, oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Thank you.
It turns out that when the characters initially come out, they will stand around for about 30 minutes taking photos, and then they'll do the show. We're tired. We're going to bed.
Our last time scanning in. Ooh, what is our towel animal today?
What is that? Is it a genie?
Yes, it must be a genie, because obviously Aladdin was tonight. So.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty good.
It's a genie. That's good. That's great.
Oh. You beheaded the genie! You monster!
Okay. Now we're at the end. I just want to say a massive thank you to ZAVVI for choosing to sponsor this video. Go and check out the Disney 100 collection, such as the Pizza Planet t-shirt I'm wearing right now, and the Wally t-shirt that I wore earlier. It's a great collection. They've got some fantastic lines coming later this year in the new drops, so check those out. And the competition, if it is still open, don't forget to enter the competition. You get your free entry by completing the online entry form, link in the description, and you can get 4 free entries on top of that if you place an order at ZAVVI before the closing date. So full terms and conditions are in the description. And don't forget to use my code ADAM100 to get 25% off all clothing at ZAVVI, including the Disney 100 collection, as well as 10% off the rest of the store. So thanks very much to ZAVVI. As is becoming tradition with the end of a adventure, a trip report. So, KIERAN, yes. What was your highlight?
Oh my gosh, of the whole trip, definitely had to be Paolo. Their restaurant was incredible. Our server was insane.
Shout out to Denise.
Yeah, incredible.
And I'm going to say Paolo as well, but specifically the agnolotti pasta that you had.
Yes, I'm going to be dreaming about that for weeks.
I think I might have to come back onto this ship to go to Paolo and get that pasta for myself.
Definitely.
Because having a bite and sharing it was nice, but I need yeah. that to myself. Room for improvement. What would be your thing? I can point out mine.
Yeah, you do yours, let me think.
The buttons in the elevator. They have been the only thing that I've been like, please, Disney, change those buttons. Because the second someone even gets near those buttons, all you hear is beep, 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 beep. And then you're stopping at every single floor.
Yeah. I genuinely cannot think of anything. Like, the trip has just been so incredible. Like, yes. The elevator buttons, sure. But other than that, no, it's just been so good. It's just like wildly exceeded my expectations of what a Disney cruise was going to be like.
And this has exceeded the expectations of I've had from previous cruises.
Wow.
And shout outs to Mariana in the concierge team.
Yes.
She's been above and beyond.
Yeah.
The cabana, I think, was worth the money.
Yeah, absolutely. It was such a nice little retreat.
Don't get me wrong, it's pricey, but like to have that for the full day, we actually spent the whole day on Castaway and really enjoyed our time.
Yeah. It's not essential. Like, there were plenty of open chairs out on the beach, but if you can afford it and you feel like treating yourself, it's really great.
And you know what I like to say, treat yourself. So, question now comes to concierge. Is the price worth it on this itinerary and this ship?
I mean, it's really hard for me to say, because this has been my literal only experience of a Disney cruise.
But you've done other cruises in inside cabins and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it's just like, it's incredible. The level of service you get, the 2 floors of concierge, like the sun deck as well as the main lounge area.
So my only comparison to this is the Disney Magic, which me and Gary did. That series is on here if you want to go and check it out. But the lounge... The a la carte menu is outstanding. Yeah. I think I would only recommend it to you if you've done lots of Disney cruises before and you want something A, different, B, it's in your budget, and C, you're going to spend a lot of time in there. We have purposely gone out of our way to spend more time in the concierge lounge, but because it's KIERAN's first cruise, we've also spent a lot of time going around the ship.
Right.
If you wanted to relax in that space.
Yeah, you could easily spend your entire cruise in the concierge
and we met someone who did.
Yeah, we did.
And he's done 40 plus cruises.
Yeah.
So,
nice.
One day. But in the meantime, it has been an utter joy having
Kieran along.
Yes, well, let me take this a second to say thank you so much.
Oh no, for my pleasure.
Me. This has been just truly incredible. I really never thought I would come on a Disney cruise, and look at it. It happened. So I'm very, very thankful for Adam to bring me.
It's honestly, it's been so easy having you here, and a blast.
Great.
Sentiments aside, I do need to finish the vlog. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to all the future stuff. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.